Hello everyone, I'm back again, playing IL-2 again, but with a brand new campaign, in a brand new plane, a brand new theatre of war. As you may have guessed from the introduction, I shall be flying the JU-88, and I shall be flying the JU-88 over Murmansk, hence the name of the campaign, JU-88 over Murmansk. I thought I'd try this out because there aren't that many bombing videos, I don't think, on YouTube of people playing bombers, and there'd be a nice change of pace really, and I might be better at bombing than being a fighter. Maybe not, we'll see. Okay, description: Murmansk, 1941. This will be the start of Operation Barbarossa, which is the invasion by Nazi Germany, invading Soviet Russia. The KG-30 has been transferred to the High North to support the offensive against Murmansk. Its mission is to attack targets around Murmansk in order to crush the Russian defenders. Missions to be flown will range from airfield strikes to railroad hunting and direct support of the ground troops. This campaign is based on actual events. Many of the missions actually occurred in similar form. Start with the campaign with the rang of Major. Of course, that means rank. This is a 10-mission campaign. I hope you like and enjoy it, by UG. Thank you, UG. So I'm going to select Major. The rank, difficulty, all this stuff will still be on. Take off instant success, and I want the speed bar. Leave that okay, and let's see. Actually, I think I'll keep the player map icon off because I'll show you when we get into the plane, but this one has actually a compass which tells you where to go. So let's try with the map icon off so we don't really know where we are. Yes. So let's start. Here's the map. I'm not 100% sure where Murmansk is. Oh, actually, I know. It's like, this is basically Scandinavia over here. And you go up around, and Murmansk is on the top here, on top of Russia. Okay, gentlemen. Gentlemen, welcome to the Northern Front. Today our campaign to take Murmansk begins. Our mission is to support our troops on their way to Murmansk, primarily attacking enemy airfields and providing our troops with close air support if necessary. Today we will attack the airfield at Vayenga. Primary targets are aircraft parked on the ground and any airfield installations of vital importance. One flight of ME-110s will provide escort for today. Enemy flak and fighters will be on the prowl. But it shall be nothing compared to what we saw against England! Yeah, so that was my German accent. I might not bring it out again. Good luck! Attacks from high altitude, around 3,000 metres, should be performed with dive bombing throughout this campaign. The skin to be used is JU-88-840. Okay, right. So, let's take a look at our plane. Here it is. As you can see, it's got like a winter camo, so it's looking very white. Which I guess is appropriate for a Nazi plane, maybe? Oh god. We saw them obviously, didn't get a massive amount of action against them. We saw them in the last mission, tried to shoot one down and failed miserably. So let's hope I don't fail again. We'll leave the bomb delay to zero. Yeah, I think that's everything. Maybe I should change my pilot skin. Not that it really matters. Oops. I want a DE. There, that'll do. I don't know. You can't really see it anyway. Apply, we've got four bombs, and we're going to be doing dive bombing. You can do level bombing and dive bombing with the plane. I've practiced both, so I've got a basic idea of what I'm doing. So, let's see how it goes. I'll click fly, and I'll see you in the plane. Okay, so here we are in the plane. This is the cockpit. Pretty nice. I'm a flight leader now, so I have responsibilities, which makes me a bit nervous. We need to turn the engines on one by one, so let's start with engine one. See, there's some dials on the outside of the engine there. Not sure what they mean. Engine two, start that one. There we go, and all engines selected. Okay, now I came into this cockpit before, and I don't think the compass was working in the way I was expecting it to. So I've turned on the player icon again, just so I know where I am. Otherwise, we might get a bit lost. All right, so let's take off. Flaps to take off and throttle up. That's the throttle there. Those yellow controls. Ten percent. We're now at 170 kilometers an hour, so we should be able to gently take off. And there we go. Excellent. All right. So yes, I've changed the speed bar to show kilometres an hour and metres now, because that's what the Germans use, being on the mainland of Europe, whereas us Brits still use the imperial system. Change the flaps to combat, and let's just make sure we're going the right way. So we need to get up to 3,000 meters altitude, then dive bomb some planes on a runway, apparently. So while I'm climbing, let's have a quick look at some of the controls. There's the artificial horizon, compass, this thing. This is the climometer. Shows we're going at 5. Meters per second. Altimeter, or altimeter, or whatever the hell you call it. Speedometer, something else. Oh, flaps are raised. Oh yeah, that's another thing. The flaps raise automatically once you get above a certain speed. I think it's above 216 kilometers an hour. Then you have to stay at raised flaps. You can't put the flaps down over that speed. Where were we? Some other stuff. Clock. It's 10 a.m. More compasses. And over here we've got things like temperature readings and RPM readings. And over here is the fuel gauges and what have you. Yeah, all right, and that I think is a bomb site. Cool. So we're at 630 meters. We're gonna throttle down to 90 and take the prop pitch down to 90. And from my training with this plane, it has an optimum climb speed of 270 kilometers an hour, I think, maybe 250. Can't remember now. Somewhere around there, doesn't really matter. So I'm going to need to try and maintain that while climbing. Alright, so that's it. It's got a nice visibility in the cockpit, lots of glass. That does mean that I guess I'm more vulnerable to bullets through the cockpit. Does also have other crew members. There's one bombardier or navigator person who sits there. Also has a forward firing gun. There's another guy who sits back there who controls the those two guns there in the rear. And finally there's a guy who lies on the floor there and has a gun on the bottom of the plane. And he spends the whole time just lying on his belly, hoping to shoot somebody from behind. And you can switch between the different positions. But know if I'd like to be sacked so close to the bombs, to be honest, but never mind. Yeah, so what I can do actually is, if I get under attack by enemy fighters, I can put the plane into level mode. It has a mode which makes it stay completely level, and I can navigate away from the cockpit and take control of the guns to try and fight off the enemy fighters. So that should be interesting. And I think that's about it. I don't have anything else I can think of I need to say. It's going to be a fairly long flight to the target area over here, so I'm going to continue on my merry way, continue climbing to 3,000 meters, and I'll come back very shortly. Okay, so I'm now back. Obviously I'm back, as you can hear me and see me. We're just about, well, not even close to halfway to the target yet, so still some way to go. I've got my level stabilizer on, and we're at about 3,000 meters. As you can see, we're at 3,000 meters there. The climometer is fairly stable. Looks like we're kind of dropping altitude a little bit, so I'll just trim the elevator up a bit. And one thing I want to explain before we get into flying here. 4 of us. Yeah, there's 4 of us in our flight. And the BF-110s are down there, protecting us. So one thing I need to explain is the bomb site. There are 2 separate bomb sites, one for dive bombing, which is controlled by the pilot from this position, and one for level bombing, which is controlled by the navigator slash bombardier from this position. Let me see if I can... there we go. So this is the level bombing one. Just bring it up. And I think the campaign said we're supposed to be doing dive bombing, so I might not get to use this much, although I will see if I can get an opportunity to do so. And with this one, you need to set your altitude, set the plane speed. It's hard to see it with the white background. And then, for example, you would lock onto the target by pressing a button, and then the sight would automatically scroll downwards, keeping the crosshair on the target depending on the altitude and speed readings you had inputted. It's a little bit more tricky than that though, because you've got to put in the true airspeed, which isn't the speed, I believe, which is shown on the speed bar. The speed bar is the indicated airspeed, which is what your plane is telling you is how fast you're going. The true airspeed is actually different due to things like wind and turbulence and things like that, which kind of changes it. I think the true airspeed is usually slightly higher than the indicated one. So that's that. If you go back to the pilot seat, the pilot also has a bomb sight, which is an automated bomb sight, which tells him when to release the bombs during a dive. And same principle, you set the altitude. So if you set it up to 3,000, we're at 2,980 at the moment. That might change when we get closer though. And we set the speed. Now the speed's going to be quite high because we're obviously diving. Let me see if I can find my notes to see what we should have it. I think it should be at like 500. Sorry, I'm just looking away, trying to find my notes. 400 kph, 500 is a bit high. So you need to set the velocity to 400 kph, because that's around about the speed you'll be going when you start to dive. And what it will do is it will automatically bring up on the crosshair here a little cursor showing where your bombs are going to land. So you need to try and make sure the target is on that cursor. And once you get to the... With the dive bombing, you set the altitude as the drop altitude. So that's the altitude you're going to drop the bombs. And we want to do that fairly low at 500 meters. So when you get to 500 meters in your dive, it will set off an extremely loud and annoying buzzer noise, which will indicate that you need to drop the bombs. So you drop the bombs, pull up, and hopefully they should land directly on the target. So that's the theory behind it. I have done a bit of practice and I've been okay with it so far. So hopefully we should be okay. Where are we? You can't see us on this white map. Oh my god, we're off course a little bit. Need to change that. Also climb a bit so we've got a bit more height. Yeah, okay. Speed top time a little bit, get back on course. Yeah, so that's that. Hopefully we won't have such an issue with frame rate problems this time, because there shouldn't be as many aircraft in the air, at least to start with. I don't know what the later missions are going to be like, but this one's kind of going to be just a taster mission, really. Level stabilizer on, and we're back on course, kind of. So, yes, all right. So I'm going to skip another bit of video while we're just flying along, and I'll see you at the target. Okay, so here we are. We're just coming up to the final waypoint before we start our bomb run. And there's a frozen lake right beneath us, and this is where we need to turn. So turn off the stabilizer. Make a right hand turn here. Cross this big river. And the airfield should be over there somewhere. There we go. All right. Got our friends here. Don't know where the 110s have gotten to. Don't see them anywhere. And that's the airfield up ahead. Alright, so it's go time. Make sure all our settings are still calibrated. 500 meters drop height, 400 kilometers true airspeed. Get settled in my seat. Alright, okay, so what we need to do. Wait until the airfield has passed underneath our feet. So basically we've gone past it, then we need to roll over like that and dive straight downwards pretty much, and wait for the horrible buzzer noise. Where are we? Looks like we're slightly off course here, so the airfield is actually on this left. Turn off the map, don't need that. Where are these planes? There's a quite large group of them off on the right hand side, I think I saw. So we'll aim for that area. I'm going to tell my squad mates to attack. They won't do dive bombing though, because they're too stupid. So they're just gonna do some kind of crazy bombing. Is this a different airfield? I thought we were. Is that. Are there two airfields? Right? I'm confused. That doesn't look like what I saw earlier on. Oh god, and look, there's a red fighter down there. There's a Soviet fighter. Okay, I'm gonna roll over. Oh, there it is. I thought I'd gone past it. Extending the air brake. Oh shit. deploy, and we do have some lag here. Where are the enemy planes? I think they're here. As you can see, there's a crosshair there. These are all on fire. I'll try for these ones here. And there's the horrible klaxon. Bombs away. Enemy aircraft destroyed. Yeah, we destroyed some aircraft right there. Oh god. Oh my. Holy shit. Oh my god. That was scary. You bastard. It's a Russian I-16. And I believe they were the early Russian fighters before they had the Yaks. And the LAs and all that kind of stuff. Okay, time to get my guys to rejoin formation because we need to have a tight formation to fend off these fighters here. Being shot at some more. Whoops, wrong one. I'm confused. I need blah, 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 tactical Titan formation. Okay, we're going the wrong way as well. We need to go this way. Some engines overheating as well. Jesus Christ! Evasive action. I need help. Where the hell is this plane that was shooting at me? Oh, okay. I'm gonna switch on the level stabilizer. Oh, looks like my guy in the back is wounded here. There you are, you bastard. We're pulling away from him now. He's almost a kilometre away, so it's a bit too far away to actually shoot. I've got one JU-88 following me. I don't know where the rest of them gone. Maybe they're all dead. Are they all dead? And I don't know why he's in like a line, a breast formation. That's a wrong formation. Tactical, change formation, echelon right. What's the map looking like? Kind of off course, but that's okay. And we're definitely pulling away from this fighter here, so that's good. Both engines still seem to be working fine. Yeah. Okay, let's try and get back on course. God, that's awful when somebody's just shooting the hell out of you and you can't really do very much because you're in a massive bomber which turns really badly. Luckily these are, as I said before, just early war fighters, so they won't be very potent. It's the later war ones with the cannons and things we'll watch out for, because if they shoot you, they can take you down with one pass. I don't understand why this guy is following me like this. Try something else. Brake. Gosh, I may know. I think because I asked for help and now he's kind of covering me by following me. Brake. Rejoin. Does that work? Maybe if I tell him Target all. Oh, I don't know. I think it's moving now. Oh, we need to be up in course as well. Okay, level stabilizer on. Alright, so I think this guy is basically given up. A bit of flak going off. It's a pity I didn't get a chance to shoot at him from the rear gunner's position, but I was too busy trying to pilot the plane in the right direction, unfortunately. No idea where the rest of my squadron is. Send them to the next waypoint. Oh look, we have got a bit of fuel leakage going on there from the left engine. We came with full tank fuel though, so we should still have enough. Yeah, so that was it. That was my bomb run. Fairly exciting, but then, you know, once you've done the bombing, that's it. It's time to go home. And I don't know how the rest of the campaign's going to work out, whether it'll actually be any good to watch, but just have to take it as it goes. Let's speed up time a bit. Quite low, but that doesn't really matter because we're heading home and speed is the main priority right now. Just veering off course a bit, so let's get back on that. Alright, so actually all I could do, I guess, is I could take a look at what else is going on. Here's the other JU-88, which I've somehow lost. Don't know what he's doing. There's the BF-110s. All seem to be present and correct. And that's me again, so no enemy fighters left. Oh, look at these. Oh, these are ours. Float planes. That's nice. What's this? This is somewhere. This is a town. Airfield. Are these just kind of target locations? Oh, there is an enemy plane. Yeah, so this is the I-16. I'm not too familiar with it and what it's capable of. As you can see, it is an open cockpit, which must have been horrible in, like, you know, if you're flying in the north of Russia during winter with all this snow and the winds and what have you. Wouldn't have enjoyed doing that. Yeah, so that's it. That's the only enemy fighter who's left. Seems to be taking it easy. Maybe he's got some engine damage. But yeah, that's who we're going to be facing up against, at least initially. Alright, so not much action going on elsewhere, so I'll skip the video and get to the landing part. Okay, I've just noticed something a bit alarming. Check the fuel gauge and it's dropped by a great deal. It's almost at zero. I think it's those yellow ones. So I'm going to turn propage down, throttle down to 80, and try and make our fuel last until we get back to our airfield. There is another airfield in our path, so if it comes to the worst, we might be able to land there. But we shall see. Keep an eye on that and I'll keep you updated. Alright, well, we now appear to be at zero fuel, which is obviously a bit of trouble. I don't know how long it's going to last before it actually runs out in the game. So, landing at this airfield over here is probably a good idea. I've got no idea where my friend has gone. He was right behind me, now he's vanished. Terrible discipline. They lack discipline. Okay, so we're gonna make an emergency landing. That's the FAT controller. He says we can land, so that's good. And this is the airfield we're gonna use. Yeah, we're basically running on fumes right now, I think. So I need to try and get lined up. Throttle down to about halfway. This is a bit different to Battle of Britain 1 because we now have an actual runway rather than just a big field. A big bumpy field. So it makes it a bit easier in some ways because you don't have to worry about accidentally landing on them a load of potholes, but you also have to line yourself up correctly with the runway, which can be tricky, for me at least. I'm going to keep going parallel to it and then make a big right hand turn. Turn around 180 degrees. Hopefully our fuel will last that long. Where is it? Start making the turn now. Also need to bleed off some speed. Oh god, the engine's out of fuel. Okay, well, here's one thing we can do in this situation. We can feather the props, and that will turn them so they're on the, you know, sideways to the wind, which gives me a bit more aerodynamicity, whatever the hell you call it. But this is interesting. My first mission, and I've got thing is called a dead stick landing. I think that's a technical term where you don't have any power whatsoever and you're just gliding in. Now hopefully I will have enough speed to make it to the runway, otherwise we may be in a bit of trouble. The worst comes to worst, we'll just have to do a belly landing, which will fuck up the propellers, but at least we'll all be alive. Right, need to keep an eye on the speed. We're at 220 kilometers an hour, coming down fairly fast. Once I lower the flaps and lower the gear, then the speed's going to drop considerably, so I need to do that, I think, at the pretty much at the last second. I don't know if I'm going to make it. Stay in the air, stay in the air. 170. No. Just short. Oh well. So we've snapped off our propeller blades, and we've got a fair amount of bullet holes in our plane. But we're alive. We made it. Oh, what was that? It was a shadow. Was that the other plane? Who was that? Is it one of these? Oh, it is. I think. Maybe. Yeah, that's me down there. It's BF-110s. Whoops! Didn't mean to do that. First escape accident. Yeah, it's the BF-110s just flying over us. There they are. Bye, guys! Thanks for the help! Alright, I'm gonna tell the rest of my schwarm to return to base, because I'm out of action. And that's that. So, quick mission. Enemy ground kills, one. We killed one plane on the ground. I thought we might have got more than that, but I think most of them had already been taken out by my colleagues. So that was the first mission of JU-88 over Murmansk. Thanks for watching. And I'll be back shortly with the next thrilling installment. Not assortment, installment. All right, that's it. Thank you. Goodbye.